So, Marty, how's your, you know, you've been off the wagon now. How long have you been off the ale and the substances?
18 months.
Sam, have you, what happened then last night, or was you?
Oh, I got tempted badly last night. You know, when you talk about, yesterday, actually, afternoon, you talk about the higher power, and, you know, there being some sort of spiritual, cosmic thing going on. Mm-hmm. I was just lying there, I'd be in the gym, doing everything right. Got everything right in my head, and then I just lying there thinking about one of my old mates who's, you know, we used to knock around together when we were in there, that chaotic lifestyle, you know, and off my harness all the time, and we did have fun, but it was dangerous at times, and he was a bit of a dangerous character to be around, and anyway, I was just thinking about him at that specific second, and then tap, tap, tap on the door, my daughter, dad, so, went out, I won't mention no names, and he's like, how are you? Come on, let's go. We've got loads of dough. I'll pay for everything. Let's go over to Lark Lane and get off our bouncers. I said, no, I can't do it. Just have a cup of tea. So we had a cup of tea, and I started telling him about letting Jesus into my life, and he liked it.
Is that it then? Yeah, so that, Jesus saved you?
Yeah, Jesus saved me. It was there, like the devil knocked on me door. So as soon as I started talking about Jesus living inside my heart, he done a runner. And you know, but it's like,
it's good advice, that though, isn't it? You know, if you like, you know, want to stay sober, yeah, and someone knocks, like your old mates, mention Jesus.
Yeah. You just do a runner right away.
So did you go to church today?
No, I'm actually an atheist, to be honest, but.
Oh, Sunday, I love it. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, man.